Üdvözlök mindenkit, és köszönöm a meghívást. That's it. Thank you for inviting me here, and I will try to speak about cloud computing in the next 2 hours, a bit less, okay? And I was a bit surprised by the name of the event, Google NAP. And I asked what NAP means in Hungary, and said, yeah, because in English, NAP is a siesta, and I hope you will not take a nap when I am speaking, okay? So, let's go on, and the next 10 years, 2010-2020, will be very important in the IT world. I will be speaking mostly for IT people in large or medium organizations. It's going to be what I call the cloud decade, and the question is, how do you start today your trip to the cloud? Okay, and I am the founder and the chairman and chief cloud evangelist of Wavevol. Wavevol is one of the key partners of Google, and we have a wonderful team in Hungary with 3 people. Thomas is not, and Agnes, I don't know if they are in the room. Where are they? Okay, there are 3 great people here. Okay. So, what's going on? Every 10 years, there is a big change in IT. 1990 came the first PC that worked more or less, Windows 3. You remember this one. At that time, a lot of IT managers said, no PC. Now they have a PC that they want to get rid of. 2000 came Internet, the web. And the same thing happened, where organizations are slow to accept it. We are now entering 2010, the world of cloud computing. And this is going to be as big or bigger than the web or the PC. So let's try to understand what will be what is cloud computing and what will be the impact. So 2010. Before I start, I think I am very optimistic about cloud computing, especially for countries like Hungary, because you can get the best IT solution today at the same level than you can get in New York, in Paris, or San Francisco. So that's a great news for countries like your country. There are 2 parts in IT, infrastructures and applications. What is infrastructure? Workstation, networks, servers. What is cloud IT infrastructure? Very simple. You need high-speed networks, like the one we have in this room. Wi-Fi is available here and upstairs. It was available in my hotel yesterday. So you need speed and networks. Without networks, no clouds. Second, servers. In real cloud computing, servers out. In our organization, Wavevol, about 120 people in 12 countries, we have 0 servers. Everything is run by Google or other providers. And third, access tools, very simple. A mobile tool, a tablet, a smartphone, a PC, a Macintosh, and a browser. Nothing else. So that's the one I want to explain in a few minutes. First, networks. Networks. High speed. The next generation, today you have in your country 3G working, Wi-Fi working. The next generation is called LTE, long-term evolution. When you go to dinner tonight, you can speak with your friend and you say, do you know something about LTE? And then your knowledge of IT will look very great, okay, if you speak LTE. LTE is the next generation, and it has 2 or 3 key points. First, high speed, starting today at 150 megabytes per second download and 50 up. And when we go to next 2014, it will go something like 1 gigabyte. So that's a lot of speed. And the other key point, good point, this is a universal standard, the same worldwide. So if you have a smartphone here in Budapest and you travel anywhere, you can access high speed all the networks. I checked before speaking this morning, and 2 at least of the key operators in your country, Telenor and T-Mobile, are experimenting with LTE. So it's coming. Not tomorrow morning, but maybe 2020. So, point 1. So cloud network 2050, you will get wireless. Also, this is very interesting in your countries. You had no wire, so you went wireless for voice. The same thing will happen for information, for IT, wireless. Second point, high speed, 100 megabits per second minimum, reasonable. You can do some work with 100 megabits per second. Whatever the technology, it works. Okay. I have an Android phone or a Google phone, whatever you want to call it, and it can receive 3G, do Wi-Fi or whatever. So network will be available almost everywhere. Good coverage. Reasonable cost, let's say 40 euros per month, average, per person. And so we get all our needs covered. Point one, networks are available. Simple. Point two, servers. We are back in IT to big central servers. And there are three families of clouds. First, public cloud. When we first spoke about clouds in 2007, there was only one public cloud. What is a public cloud? It's a set of servers which are managed by a company which is not yours. Google, Amazon, Microsoft, or whatever. So you rent resources. But public cloud is very dangerous for classical IT. So the vendors invented something very strange, which is called private cloud. Private cloud is the name of your existing IT. So now if you have a computer in your room, you have a private cloud. Okay. You know what is private cloud? You know this strange animal you find in the Himalaya, the Yeti. Everybody speaks about it, nobody's seen it. It's the same with private cloud. They don't exist. But that's the way a lot of vendors try to adapt the cloud to their old, obsolete technologies. Third one, community cloud. This is more important. Community cloud means you get a resource which is shared for one industry. I will give you one example in a few seconds. So whatever the cloud, we share resources. This is, for example, one of the Google data centers. Okay. The number I will give you are not official Google numbers. I don't work for Google, so I can say stuff which is not Google official. Okay. How many servers are there in Google data center? More or less something like 2.4 million. This is changing, of course, every month. They all run Linux, of course, this is the only one which works. Okay, so it's Linux or Linux, okay? And on more or less 40 data centers worldwide. I know they are building one in Austria, one in Belgium, in the US, in China, all over the world. So when you work on Google data centers, you are sure to get huge resources, huge IT. I was speaking about community cloud. This is a good example. This small data center is in Munich, in Germany. It runs Amadeus. Amadeus is for the airline industry, the transportation industry, and they run reservation for 150 airline companies. This is a resource, big computer, huge resources shared by the airline company. As an example, in this Munich data center, they can run on diesel for 6 months. So if Munich has no electricity for 6 months, we are in big trouble. Okay, so they can run for 6 months. Typical German. Okay. So public cloud, this image is one from Microsoft. They are building a data center in Chicago, you know, by containers, the big containers. Each container has a minimum of 2,000 servers. So this means that when you add up something, you add a minimum of 2,000 servers. So everybody of the big names is building huge data centers. No place for amateur. You cannot play the game if you don't invest a minimum of 500 to 1 billion US dollars per year. This is a game of very, very, very large organization. Some of the names, by alphabetical order, Amazon, Google, IBM, Microsoft, they are all building. I forgot one, Apple. Apple is finishing a big data center in North Carolina, which costs $1 billion. So some of the big names are working on this one, which is good because they have worldwide installation and very competitive prices. As you know, on Google or Amazon, you can share and access resources which are very, very inexpensive. The second point is a good point. We have a lot of resources when needed. That's public cloud on the server side. Okay. And how do you access the cloud? For some IT managers, when they think of access tools, they think a very strange machine. You remember it? A PC with Windows? You remember this one? Okay. So that was the old way of working. Now what do we need? We need something which is very simple. We need something with a browser. So the real basic decision you are going to make, any tool which has a good browser is okay. It could be a PC, a smartphone, a tablet. Of course, it has to be multi-platform, like Chrome, for example. I run a Macintosh. I would love to test a new browser by Microsoft called Internet Explorer 9. It's not available on the Macintosh, so I survive without it. Okay? Respect of the web standard and a lot of performance. This is important. You will spend your life on a browser, as we do in Revelo. And I checked some numbers from Onlyria, and the numbers are very interesting. So you are one of the few countries in the world where Microsoft Internet Explorer is not number one. In fact, it's number three. You get Internet Explorer went down, 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 keep going down. Then you have Firefox, almost stable, and the new one coming up quickly from Google. And if you check this number, you have the stat counters. If you look at the numbers, for example, for Europe, Europe is behind compared to your country. You are more advanced in new browsers compared to France or Germany or any country in Europe. Okay. So we have good browsers available. Fine. And what is the option? What are the options today for an IT manager? What we call fat clients. What is a fat client? Okay, get some strong image. You know. Okay. That's fat client. You want some names for IT? I just add some name by accident, maybe. You know this one? Or Office? So this is what we offer today to the users. Big software nobody needs. Okay. So there is an alternative, which is not good either, called thin client. So the choice is obesity or anorexia. Thin client would be, for example, Citrix. So the good news today is that we can get rid of fat client and rid of anorexic client. We can use normal client, which are healthy, with a good browser. And the second point is mobility. We spoke a lot today about mobility. These numbers from Morgan Stanley are very interesting. For the first time, as you can see, in 2006, mobile devices went over fixed devices, desktop. If you look at the number for desktop, you see, it's stable. About 150 million per year sold worldwide. Where is the growth? Growth is on mobility. If you are in 2000, if we go to 2013, we get 80% mobile. This is our laptops, and the other one, the big one, is for smartphones and tablets. So 80% of the tools you will buy will be mobile tools. And you all in the room have mobile tools. I have mobile tools, like everyone. Okay, so 80% mobile with a browser. Third point also, I want to, what we call now cloud-connected device. And I'm sure my person from Google speaking after me will speak about Chrome OS and Android. Cloud-connected device are mobile. And I think this message from Google is very interesting. Web meets phone. We are on a phone connected to the web. It could be a big phone like a tablet. Okay. So mobile, 80%. Whatever the network is working, it's okay. Running, perfect. Okay. Laptop, smartphone, Chromebook, no tablet, whatever you want. In Webevol, we have a very simple way of working. Every new employee comes in and buy its own tool on his own money. And we are allowed by French law to give everyone 50 euros per person per month to pay for the device. 50 euros over 18 months, that's 1800 euros, that's a nice machine. And what is the value? First, I have no investment. Second, nobody comes to me and says, I don't like it. They made the choice. And third, if they leave, which they don't leave, but if somebody leaves, I stop paying. So anybody can come in with a Mac, a PC, a big one, a small one, I don't care. They use it. We are on the web, on the cloud. Okay? No applications, of course, and reliable, low cost, reasonable cost, and very good security. I'm sure when we were speaking of Chrome OS is one of the most secure machines you can buy today. So to summarize, for an IT manager, what are the tools you need to work today and tomorrow? Very simple. Good networks that are available, mostly will be high speed, mobile. Then you need clouds, private, public, or community. I will explain how to choose. Then a browser, and whatever device you need. So you can enter with a PC, with a smartphone, with any device, it works. That's very simple. So that's the basic infrastructures. But the second point, which is even more important, what for? How do you use it? What we call application. And then we speak in our world of SaaS, software as a service. And the change in SaaS is very, very, very important. Okay, can you jump to SaaS? Is it dangerous? No. A lot of companies do it. Okay. 3 points. First, on the public cloud or on a community cloud. If a vendor comes to you and says, I have a good SaaS solution, I have a trick for you. You want to make sure it is a real SaaS, you discuss with the vendor, and after a few minutes you can say, okay, well, you know, the security of the cloud, I am not convinced. Can I install the application inside my firewall? If you say yes, clack, you know it's not SaaS. Real SaaS, you cannot install in your own organization. Okay? Point two, multi-tenant. I will explain in 1 minute. And third, the new business model. Multi-tenant is maybe the most specific definition of software as a service. It means you share an application. For example, I take Amazon, not to speak always with Google. I'm sharing one here. Somebody else is using a flat here, and we share it. Which means something important. First, we have only one version of the software for everybody. The same one. One version. Okay, I cannot modify it. If I want to run a CRM application, a commercial application, I decide to select a product, could be Salesforce or whatever product. I speak to the marketing manager. I said, I have selected Salesforce. I said, okay, great, how can I modify it? And you say, I cannot. I have to use it the way it is. Something very important, okay? So we can share it. So if it's running for 20,000 organizations, if you are the 20,001, it's running also for you, the same one. And if it's not running for anybody. So everyone knows about it, and the vendor has to fix it quickly. Okay? And you have always the last version. So these are key components of a SaaS application. We share the same application. Lot of advantage. First advantage, last version. Okay? I can, of course, modify the logo, do some changes. Like when I buy a car, I can buy a car with an open sailing or some options. But I am buying a car, an industrial car. Okay? I cannot create my own specific application. Okay? We have all the same version. So we access to the best practice, the best version in the world. And really, I think, at the end of it, it's very simple. If I run on the cloud, I am in Budapest, I am in New York, I am in Paris, I am in Dakar, I am in Ouagadougou, I am in Tokyo, I have the same application. So every organization, small, large or medium, gets the same best application worldwide, from D1, which is amazing. And business model, no software. We don't buy software, okay? No software license, no maintenance. For example, there is a very small German software company in 3 letters, starting by S, You may know the company, three letters, okay? Last year they were upset because they were not selling too much software, which is normal, so they decided to increase the cost of maintenance from 17% to 23%. And they said to their client, we have good news for you, we are increasing the cost of maintenance. Okay. On service, on software as a service, you pay a cost per month or per year. For example, Google is 40 euros per year per person. It depends on the number of users and you can go up and down. For example, now we have 120 users on Revevol.Europe. If we want to go to 140, I have to buy 20 more. So it's very simple business model. So that's it. So to summarize these 2 points on infrastructure and application, what is changing for IT managers? One more time, I'm speaking mostly to IT managers. We don't speak anymore of integration. We have componentry, like industrial companies. So the infrastructure, private cloud, public cloud, community cloud, and you enter by a browser. So the guy in charge of infrastructure gives his direction to the guy in charge of application. Everything which runs on the browser is okay. Any application you are going to buy starting tomorrow, which does not run on the browser, should be verboten. Okay. And what kind of application? It's very, the how the business is changing. Business is changing quickly. You have what we call structured application, normal application, like a business process. What is a business process? It's an application that if it interests a bank, will not work in a petroleum company, or vice versa. If I have an application that runs a real-time petroleum refinery, I cannot sell it to a bank. It doesn't interest the bank. Then you have what we call support application like CRM, human resource management, budgeting, which are generic. And then everything which is called social computing, we spoke a lot about it today, office automation, like the application we have today on the desktop and on the server, and the new application that was, you know, like blog, wikis, search and everything. Well, that's the key component of an IT system. Okay. How do we change it? Very simple. Migration, starting next Monday. Everything which is on the shared, on the social computing, goes on the public cloud. Running in 2011, in a medium or large organization in Hungary, a mail server is nonsense. Nobody does it anymore. Some people do, they will change next Monday. Okay? All the generic application support processes are also available on public cloud. It could be SuccessFactors for human resources, Salesforce for CRM, adaptive planning for budgeting, or whatever. So if I am an IT guy, everything which is generic on public cloud. Then if my business application, business processes, if they are available like airlines on a community cloud, great, and otherwise I will move to the private cloud. So the strategy is very simple. You start by public, everything you can on public. When it's done, then you keep what is left on a private. Okay? So it's a big challenge. Today, most organizations, 95% of organizations are here. They run licensed software on in-house computers. There are two places which doesn't make any sense, licensed on the cloud and SaaS inside. So the moving to the new way of working, SaaS on the cloud, takes time. It could be, if you are a large organization, 3 to 5 years, a medium size, 12 months, but you have to migrate in this direction. Okay, that's a big challenge, that's the way that the business of Revevol, helping organizations move to the cloud and to the SaaS. Okay. And I will summarize with the first big step, universal step, which is communication and collaboration. This is, these are your offices today. Okay. Some of you may be running, how do you name this word processing software? You know, Word? You remember it? Okay, that's, okay. Buying in 2011 a software like Office is buying a typewriter. It's obsolete. Okay, so we have to change it. Okay. So how do you change it? Well, you have good solutions today on the market. For example, Google, of course. It works on any organization, any size, any country. This is the reason why Webevol is moving worldwide quickly. Okay. We estimate that there are today 1 billion users of Microsoft Office. 2020, zero. So our market is simple, 100 million people to migrate every year. It's a nice market for everybody, okay? It's cost saving, but the biggest challenge, the one we are facing every day, are cultural. Getting somebody to say, I will not work anymore with Excel, with Word, with takes time. Technically it works, but human side is difficult, okay? Also, if somebody comes to you with this kind of software, okay, what is your answer in French? No thanks, you don't need it anymore. Okay. So Google, one more time, is a good example. We work a lot with Google, as you can imagine. They have a very good solution, one for education, free. So you can get all the Hungarian school universities on Google for zero. That's nice, €0, okay? Or €0, the same, okay? Google for Business, the one you're using in organization, €40 per year per person, not very expensive. Alternative to all the old tools, the classical, old-fashioned tools you had before, Office, Exchange, and SharePoint, as an example. One of the key points also of this new solution, which is very interesting, is the fact that you don't have versions. If you take, for example, Google, every week, there is a new function. You don't have to buy 2000, 2003, 2007, 2010. No, you just use, okay. So, for example, Google Ads is a brand new product, was announced in Paris in 2007, and then they added a presentation a few weeks later, then the months later, then Site, which is the equivalent of SharePoint, then they had the offline, Google Gears, and on and on. Last year, I think it's something like 200 new version of the product, new function of the product were available. Okay, so everything for $50 or €40. Okay, so, what are your priorities for this year? These are your offices of today, okay? You know the product, you know some of the old fashioned. They were good 20 years ago, fine. Okay, some of the name, okay? So what do you do next Monday? Well, I can offer you a solution. You burn everything and you replace it with Google. Very simple, okay. So, summary. I'm trying to be serious about it. Cloud is coming. This is a big study by an American company called Socatec, who says that when is cloud going to be mainstream, it's going to be 2011, 2012, today. So really, you can do it, okay. So, management view, this is my information system, my IT, my information services, software as a service. For the client, the end user, you want to offer services. You are the CIO, the chief information officer. You can select your vendors, the providers from the cloud. Some company like Webevol, we get all this product together. This is what we do for a living, okay? And so I hope this vision of cloud was helpful. And so now, KCNM.